Now start the limitations of anti-periodic table. You can see that first is anomalous position of hydrogen. Hydrogen is present in the group number 1. Now we are given the position with the group number 1 because all have one valence electron. But halogen on the other side, they also require one electron to complete their octet. So hydrogen has this property also. So where to keep, with the group number 1 or with the halogen? So this is the anomalous position of hydrogen. Other position of isotope, second limitation of the Mendeleev periodic table is position of isotope. You can see the different atom of hydrogen which has a different mass. So why they have given a same position in the periodic table? According to the Mendeleev periodic table, they should given a different position which is not given to them. So this was also limitation. Next is anomalous position of you can say some pair of element. Cobalt atomic mass is 58.9. So why it comes before nickel whose mass is 58.71, and tellurium whose mass is 127.6, why it comes before iodine whose atomic mass is 126.9? So this, why this anomalous position of some of the pair of element is there. The next limitation, no resemblance of element in the subgroup. You can see that first A we have lithium, sodium, rubidium, cesium, and they are kept with the first B in the first group, copper, silver, gold. We don't have any similarity of these elements with these. Then different group for the similar elements, you can see that copper is present in first B and mercury is present in second B. They have a same property, so why they are kept in a different groups, you can say. So by this way we can say that these all are the limitations of Mendeleev periodic table, which we have some out of them we have corrected in the next table, which is modern periodic table. So that we will discuss in the next class.